Hello, everyone. My name is HydroxideAnt. Welcome to episode 122 of Background Noise. You know, I was just thinking about this before the podcast. If I didn't do this podcast, I probably could have got something really productive done in 122 weekends. You know, like, I could have learned, like, any skill in that time.
Yeah.
Anything I wanted to do. If I wanted to, like, learn guitar, I totally could have learned guitar in that time frame.
Could have been a productive member of society.
In some way, right?
Yeah.
But no, I do a podcast. On Saturdays, man. You know, this is just a thing. I don't know. I don't know. I really like doing the podcast anyway, so. Ha! Huh. I don't have a life and I'm happy about it. Yeah, mildly okay with it. Happy's a strong word. Yeah. Well,
kind of apathetic.
Yeah, I'll give you that. That's it. So, on this week's podcast, you know, we have Kat, who's on time, right?
Yeah.
Kat, you're here, right? Not late.
Always is.
Kat, I don't hear you. It's like you're not actually in the TeamSpeak. Because she's not.
She's here in spirit.
Yeah, I like to believe she is here, you know. You know, every time, like, a bell rings, like, a cat dies. That's the saying, right?
I don't know.
Yeah, that's kind of what I pictured. I don't know. Probably not, though.
The type of that where a baby gets dropped on his head, I can never remember.
Derek. Do you remember when we had an MM against a guy named the Baby Seal Clubber?
Oh my god.
That was like the saddest moment of my entire life. Because like his Steam picture was a picture of an adorable baby seal. Like, I'm like, no. Because like I'm totally thinking like every time he lost a round, he just went and clubbed the seal again.
We always talk about, like, killing babies when we're mad, so...
I do not say killing babies. I talk about punching babies in the mouth. It's completely different.
I talk about killing babies.
Probably.
Yeah, I wouldn't put that best, Jordan, honestly. I think the whole punch a baby in the mouth thing I got from you, Jordan.
Yeah, that's possible.
Yeah, I don't know. It sounds like such a nice way to get rid of your anger.
Really is.
Really?
Yeah, what are you gonna... Who are you hurting for punching a baby in the mouth?
The baby?
Exactly.
The baby won't remember. The baby does not have any memory of this event.
Just like circumcision.
Exactly.
Same concept.
It's punch a baby in the mouth. I feel like if I was to become president, I think every baby should be punched in the mouth at least once.
Builds character.
I'm sure the baby will remember when it grows up, you know, retarded.
No, it won't remember much of anything then.
Exactly. So if it doesn't remember anything... What's the problem with punching in the mouth?
I would think retards are happier, probably.
Oh, yeah.
Honestly, I would say yes, because of the whole, like, ignorance is bliss thing.
Yeah.
Like, you have to be happy, right?
I would think so.
Debatable.
Well,
I mean, when you're a kid, you're happier, because you're less intelligent.
That's true. I was a lot happier of a child than I am now.
Yeah, can confirm. I think everyone is.
Yeah. Because you don't realize the cruelness of the world yet.
Mm-hmm.
And then you get older. If you're watching this, stop aging. You'll enjoy it.
Yeah.
Let's find the fountain of youth. Good. And then tell me about it. And then I'll use it. So you know like the whole fountain of youth thing?
Yeah.
Can you get younger from that or do you stay the same age?
I don't
remember the concept enough.
Yeah, I don't either.
I feel like it brings you back the age you were when you first used it.
That makes sense.
Oh, yeah.
So it's like, you get up into your 80s, then you touch it again, and you're back at 20. And it's like, oh, there we go.
But, like, if you found it when you're 80, and, like, used it a year later, you'd be 80 again.
Yes. And you'd stay 80. That's
so disappointing.
They spend, you know, like a good 60 years of their life searching for it, find it at 80, find out it only brings you back to 80.
Oh, that would... Oh, wow. That's worse than being colorblind.
I don't know.
I mean...
Look!
I don't know about that.
Colorblind.
I'm trying to feel good about myself. you know, I don't know. It would just be so disappointing, you know, you spent your entire life searching for the fountain of youth, right?
Because, I mean, either way, you're still at risk for a heart attack.
Yeah, that's true.
You never know when you're gonna, you know, die.
That is true. You don't know when you're gonna die. We could all die right now on the podcast.
That is true.
But if that happened, and
I bet we'd hit like a million.
Yeah, I was just gonna say that if I was able to upload it somehow, or someone did, this podcast would get so many views.
Put it in your well.
I need to do that, actually. I need to
reduce from Chance's Rope Company.
Oh, yeah, from Chance's Rope Company. He's not here this week, though, so I feel like I don't need to, like, shout out the sponsor.
Yeah, I think he went down.
Oh, yeah, there. It's a lot less gay in here, I noticed.
Yeah, do you feel the heterosexual vibe in here?
I mean, we have his mother here, so it's fine.
Oh, yeah.
I mean, it's the same thing as last week, his mother and three men.
That's, like, every night. Can confirm. It's not as happy as you think it'd be. Pretty disappointing. It's like a hot dog in the hallway, dude. It's.
I mean, it's a problem when you put both hands in and clap.
Both hands in and clap. I wish. It's a problem where I can get a running start and dive perfectly in. Like all of me, and. It's disturbing, to be honest.
Let's say, audience, there's a reason why she needs three, because one and two won't do it.
Not even close. Three is, like, barely enough, in my opinion. I think we need more than three. All four of us.
Let's go.
I think that's our plans for after the podcast.
We're roasting his mom, he's not even here. Like.
I don't know what you're talking about, Derek. He's here in spirit. We said no. Kat was here in spirit. Chance could be here in spirit. Yeah, but no, I'm sure Chance's mom is a very nice lady.
Who enjoys
honestly, I'm just gonna throw this out there. I feel bad for her.
She had five kids.
And she has to deal with Chance.
Oh, this is true.
she gave the world Chance. I feel bad for her, honestly.
Yeah, gay.
I mean, that's her mark on society.
She Chance. Left Chance.
Ooh.
It's like,
right. Mull that one over.
For you time. Know, it's like, you know, like, I'm just picturing, like, all of the parents are in the, like, audience for, like, a play or something. One of the parents goes, which one's yours? Points a kid that's not Chance.
He's over there somewhere.
He's in there.
The parent of the child she pointed to is like, wait, but that's my son.
Shut up!
No, it isn't.
That's my kid, watch. I'll go take him right now.
Hey, Billy? Get over here.
My name's Timmy. Shut up.
Ha ha ha, you're so funny, Billy.
Billy, you silly little guy.
Silly little nigga.
Yeah, exactly.
I had to do it. I had to say it.
Dude, it's okay. Jacob's here in spirit. Can we just use that?
No. We all agree. Jacob is whiter than us. But he can't say the N-word.
That's true. It is a little cringy when he says it, to be honest.
Because he drops the hard R, and that's not okay.
Yeah, it's just... You know, I'll be honest. In certain situations, it sounds normal.
Sometimes,
like,
yeah.
Sometimes he says it, and I don't think about it in just, like, normal conversation. But there have been a few times in my life where I heard him saying, I'm like, yeah, this doesn't sound right. I don't think you should be saying it. How bad is that? No, we can talk about anyone, because we can just say they're here in spirit.
It's true.
Who else could we talk about? Sky's eating curry right now.
Oh, yeah.
The odds are in the favor of that, honestly.
Typical Indian.
Like... Dude, he eats so much curry. Like, it's, like, not, like, a racist thing. Like, he actually, like, most of his meals are curry.
No, honestly, back in middle school, I had two Indian friends.
Yeah.
And I went over to their house once, and literally my eyes started watering because it was so spicy. Just the air was spicy.
Wait, like, the air in the house?
The air in the house was spicy because I came over while they were cooking dinner. Oh, and, like, wow. My eyes watering just from walking in.
You're like, I can't do this. That's why, like, I'm afraid to go, like, to, like, an Indian food restaurant. To be perfectly honest. Because I know, like, I'll eat something and, like, I'll cry.
Oh, don't worry, I cry all the time.
Well, I mean, like, I mean, it's not different reasons, so.
I just mean that I have emotional breakdowns.
I mean, so. We all do. We all, that's...
Who doesn't?
Yeah, exactly. Like, we all know once this podcast ends, we take a 10-minute break so we can all cry for 10 minutes.
10?
Look, I don't want them to think we're that big losers, Mark. I don't want to tell them it's 2 hours. Damn it, Mark.
I stubbed my toe and only cried for 20 minutes.
Walk right in, sir. Welcome to the Salty Platoon. How tough are you?
I had a bowl of nails for breakfast, so...
Without any milk. Separate.
Way, sir.
You know, I was talking about this with, I was studying in a big group for my, a lab, bio, like, practical. And I was talking about the concept that I can barely remember what's on this test, but I can tell you, like, any SpongeBob quote. It's just weird how, like, memory works.
Yeah.
Right? Like, I can tell you, like, I can name, like, any SpongeBob episode and probably name a quote from it. And I didn't even feel like I was paying that much attention to it.
I think it's because, like, SpongeBob was actually fun, so your brain wants to remember it.
That's true.
Meanwhile, studying for a test that you don't really look forward to is kind of, you know, difficult to memorize.
That's true. It's not any fun. Not any fun. All right, so before I let, like, 5 hours go by without introducing everyone, I'm going to introduce everyone. Jordan's here. Hi, Jordan.
Yes, sir.
What's going on, Jordan?
What's up?
How are your 10 years of FPS experience treating you today?
All right.
You know? You know, like, do you ever tell people, like, in real life about that?
No, absolutely not.
I feel like that could totally be a good conversation opener, right, guys? Like,
yeah. I've been playing the same game basically for 10 years.
Yeah, yeah.
I haven't really done anything, but I've been playing it.
Right? It's like you meet a girl, it's like, hey, I've got 10 years of FPX experience.
What? Wow, that's like the Sahara Desert down there now.
Yeah, I just felt my dick like shrink inside of itself. And... I'm repulsed by myself when you say that.
You know, I have an idea, actually. If a girl is hitting on you and you're not into her, I have a line for you now. That's the one you use.
You know, if any girl's going to hit on me, she's usually fairly desperate. Mm-hmm. So it doesn't really work out like you would think. Like, I was dating this one chick for about a month. Mm-hmm. And her name was Agnes, so, like, right off the bat...
It's like an old lady name, to be honest.
Right off the bat, it wasn't really... Yeah, it wasn't really gonna work out for me. And I told her, like, it was before I had my current job, and so all I did all summer is I just sat on my computer for, like, 16 hours a day, and then I worked on the weekend. I told her that's all I do. And she still, like, I ended up breaking it off.
What?
Wow. She's like, can we hang out today? And I'm like, well, I don't know. I have a lot of video games to play.
That sounds like me, but with anime. It's like, but there's like, you know, 20 new episodes that I can watch.
Instead of actually seeing people, yeah. It's actually sad how many times where I choose to play Counter-Strike over going to hang out with people.
It's so much better than people.
It really is. Like, I enjoy, like, just chilling in TeamSpeak playing Counter-Strike.
Minus the autism we have to face or deal with.
Yeah, that's true. Yeah. But, I mean, like, I'd have the autism in real life, too. It'd probably be worse.
This is true.
It depends if chances of playing or not.
To be fair, we have a lot of gaming friends, so it's like, we are hanging out with people just in the comfort of our own rooms alone. Like, losers.
Yeah, exactly, you know? But, like, I mean, I'm home, and I could, like, go eat food. Like, if I wanted to, at my house, for free. For free!
And you can fart whenever you want.
Whenever you want.
You just gotta mute your mic.
Exactly, you just gotta be a little respectful. Unless you're Derek.
I mean, it could be, you know, one of the silent but deadly ones that no one's even gonna know.
Yeah, but the problem is that's, like, a super gamble, because if it smells really bad.
Then, like, but, like, yeah, if it smells really bad, you're the only one you're torturing, which is both a good thing and a bad thing. Because, like, you'd have to deal with it, and, like... But that also means no one knows it happened except you, and you can convince yourself it didn't.
Yeah, very true.
Yeah, that's what I like to think. But, yeah, I've only introduced one person. Yeah, I went to Jordan, and we went on that rant. Alright, and then we have Mark, Lyrical Phoenix. You know, okay, I'm gonna talk about this real quick, Mark. I actually do think Lyrical Phoenix is a cool name.
Oh, really?
Yeah, like, it's not a bad name. I've heard plenty of worse names, because, you know, the one conversation in college we had one time.
Yeah.
It's not the worst name ever, right?
Like, oh my god. No, but still, that was so, like, painful, because it's like... Okay, story time.
Yeah, okay, go.
My girlfriend and I were, like, having a conversation, and she finally, like, asked, like, oh, well, like, what's your gaming name? Because she's, like, a big gamer, too, so it's, yeah. Like, it just made sense. And I'm like, oh, Lyrical Phoenix. And she just starts dying. She's like, that is so bad. And pretty much my entire friend group of college laughed at me.
You know, I like it, Mark, so I'm not laughing at you. I was laughing with you.
I wasn't laughing, I was crying, Tony.
Oh, well, that's what that was. My bad. No, but, like, it's not, like, okay, we have worse names in the friend group.
Like,
yeah, that's actually pretty bad. And even in, like, our college friend group, Mark? Like, think about all the names we know. What's Rachel's name, actually? I don't know.
I have no idea. She doesn't use Steam. She only uses League.
I was going to say, do you know her League name?
No.
Oh, okay. I assume it's something.
One sec. I'll be right back.
Yeah, this, hey, what's your League name? Why, nothing. Click. That's how I want that phone conversation to go. If he's calling her.
No, I was just going to message her.
That works, too. I accept your terms and conditions. Without reading them. Like everyone else in the world. I just want to throw this out there real quick. For anyone that's watching, if you read all the terms and conditions, you have less of a life than I do.
Fair point. That's a fact.
Like, why? Have any of you ever read all of the terms and conditions in anything before?
No, never.
It's such a waste of time.
I think it was only, like, the first time I ever booted up on the internet. And then I read it, and I'm like, probably, like, halfway through, I was like, this is pointless. And just hit the
save. And then,
I think that was it.
From this.
My parents were like, you know, remember, be very safe on the internet. Don't accept anything you don't know what it is. And I'm like, oh, might as well read all these terms and conditions.
Wow.
Yeah, fuck this shit. Enter.
It was that day.
I think that was the most of it.
Yeah, exactly. It was that day that you realized. I hit accept for anything that says accept.
I mean, Tony, you want to know what's great?
What?
Like, okay, so our exams finish on the 10th, right?
Is that Tuesday?
Yeah, that's Tuesday.
Yeah.
Literally exactly a week until my birthday afterwards.
Well, let's go!
So, we party it up.
Well, let's go, dude.
After exams.
Dude, I'm hype.
I'm crying on the inside.
I am crying on the inside because I have to take the exams.
My birthday present for the past... Like, my birthday present, like, every year has always been like, oh yeah, you've got exams, like, either a week before your birthday or a week after your birthday.
Happy birthday, like, from college. It's like, why? You know, actually, last year this time, our college was still going on your birthday. Didn't get out till like the 19th, or we didn't get to like the 19th.
As I said, it's either like a week before they finish or a week after.
We're getting out really early this year, honestly.
Yeah, I know.
Like, we get out the 10th. That feels so early.
And then a month until my summer class starts.
You got a full month, man. Live
full
it up.
Full month, yep. Live the dream.
Dream on, man. So before I forget, Derek's on the podcast. Hi, Derek.
It's your mother.
I mean, your mother.
Go clean your room.
Oh, okay. What if I told you it was already clean?
fire.
Yeah, you're right.
Yeah.
Oh, Kat's in here, but I can't, like, move her in. I'm hoping someone's in there telling her.
User left your channel. User joined your channel.
That didn't help anything.
You should just be able to join, right?
Does she remember what the password is? Hello?
I just spoke to her, so hopefully, she does.
I was going to do that, which is why I asked, does she know?
Yeah, I was mid-typing, to be honest, when you said it, and, like, my push-to-talk's on my mouse.
Gotcha.
Oh, I really hope, like, someone up there is at least explaining to her. Okay, thank God.
Hi!
Oh, this is an issue again. Cat's the top name, you know. I'm not the top name anymore.
Oh, man, this is not okay.
This is upsetting.
What? You guys don't like me being on the top of the list?
No, I don't. It's my spot.
It doesn't make sense because someone is supposed to be at the top.
It's just because
Can I say something real quick? Yeah. Something that just really pisses me off. You know when you're playing a game and you're dying a lot to the same thing and it asks you if you want to change difficulty?
It's like, look, I know this is a little hard for you.
It's the most insulting thing in the world. Like, I'm already pissed off.
And now you think I'm a fucking noob.
Now you think I'm a fucking retard. That's basically like, hey, are you sure you don't want to change the difficulty to casual? No, go fuck yourself.
I could feel the anger. It's like, feel it in, like, my insides at, like, how angry Jordan was. It got me angry. I just want to be angry at something. I don't know why. Someone give me something to be angry at.
Hey, I'll call you Hydro in person next time I see you.
Why you do this?
It still bothers me when Jacob does.
Dude,
that
like, I don't understand. Like, for...
Hey.
He stops.
Hey, Hydro.
And I just ignore him. Because, no, you don't call me Hydra in person. Like, okay, it's different. Okay. So, like, if I was to meet, like, an internet friend in person, right? And they called me Hydra, different. Because they know me as Hydra.
But even then,
it's a little weird.
Accident,
right? Like... Yeah. A little weird.
Well, I mean, if I were to meet Hydra in real life, I'm so used to calling him Hydra, and I do call him Anthony, but that's, like, not usually a thing.
Yeah.
And sometimes I call him Tony. That's Lyrical's influence.
But... Sorry, Tony.
So no, it's fine. Like, honestly, I'm over. You guys call me whatever the hell you want to call me. I don't care anymore. I cared for, like, I think, like, a little bit I cared if people called me, like, on the internet, like, by my first name, but then I'm like, I gave up really fast.
You didn't like it?
You know, I think for a little bit, maybe, like, when I first got on, like, Dillman, I didn't, because I wanted the whole, like, separation thing,
yeah.
You know what I mean? Like, I wanted to be, like, this here and this here. But it kind of got ruined because a lot of people on, like, servers and stuff knew me in real life. So they called me Anthony or Tony on the server.
Yeah.
Yeah, so.
Hi.
Yeah, that's you. Fucking t-shirt.
To be fair, it was usually Jacob just because he gamed with you a lot longer than I did.
Yeah, but the issue is, I've known Jacob since fourth grade.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And I've known him since fourth grade. How is it that Hydro's the first name that comes in his head?
That doesn't make any sense.
Like, he looks at me and thinks Hydro. No! You've known me as Anthony for how many years?
It's the total opposite of your purely internet friends.
Right? Dude, no, I have internet friends that call me Tony. Like, Derek more, like, half the time calls me Tony. Like...
I call you Anthony and Tony, like, when it's a more personal conversation.
Yeah, that's true.
That's when I do it, because I'm thinking you, I guess at a deeper level.
Yeah, that makes
so
sense,
that
yeah.
That kind of emphasizes, I don't know, it makes it more personal.
It is, right?
Like, yeah, and I mean, it makes sense to, because I know you as Hydra, that's kind of like your name, almost.
It is,
so it would make sense to call you that, and I'm okay with you calling me Cat. It makes sense, that's like my name.
Yeah,
but it gets more personal when you use your actual...
Like, if I was to be like, hey, Rachel, you know, it's like, whoa, wait, hey, I'm paying more attention now. Hey, what's up?
Yeah. It suddenly got a little bit more serious.
Because things got serious. Yeah, it's like when I called Jordan Jordan.
Yeah.
Time
yeah,
out.
Really, yeah.
Sorry, Jordan. See, wow. If I said your name, though, and I capitalized a J, that's when you get offended.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, because, like, it's a lowercase J.
Jaden.
Mm-hmm. Jaden the Smurth. It's great.
I don't know if I said this on the podcast one time.
You might have.
But
it's 50-50 if you did or you haven't.
So let me tell...
Go ahead, Kat, say what you're going to say right about now.
Thanks, I will.
I think right now is a great time to say what you're about to say. Like, right now.
I would agree.
So,
Derek, would you say right now is a good time for her to talk?
Oh, yeah, absolutely.
What about Jordan? Jordan, do you think it is?
Do we have everyone's... Huh?
Do you think it's a good time for Kat to talk?
Yeah.
Yeah, okay. Well, Mark?
Thanks.
Mark?
Hmm?
It's a good time for Kat to talk.
Yeah.
Okay. Derek, go ahead.
I would like to say that I think this is like the perfect moment for Kat to start talking.
Oh, okay.
So all in favor?
All in favor, raise your hand. Alright, 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay.
Okay, so we're gonna need Snapchats.
Yeah, I need pics.
Add you guys on Snapchat first.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, okay. I think
I... That's never happened.
Just one second. I actually think I have everyone here in on Snapchat except you, Jordan.
Yeah, that's true.
That's an accurate statement. Okay, Kat, hey, I think now would be a really excellent time, like an interval of time, for your voice to start talking about something you would like to talk about.
So
the brain has to process it first, though. You can't just talk, like, because you can talk without thinking first, which, you know, I do it a lot. It's okay, but, like, sometimes, like, you know, if it's important, you just want to think about it first.
I'm gonna cry.
Oh, don't cry. I think you should talk. Instead.
Anyway, okay, so, last summer that I went to this summer camp, this is on the topic of names, by the way. We spent, like, in a minute talking about when I should talk. But at this summer
like
camp
right now
I went
time.
To last year, instead of going by my real name, I wanted to go by Kat. Which is okay, because I've been wanting to integrate that as, like, a nickname for me for a while, but, like, people at my school totally wouldn't take it. But these people at this camp, they don't know me. So I just, like, put my name as Kat on my name tag, and that's what people called me. And sometimes I forget that that's what they know me as. So they'll, like, comment on my Instagram, or they'll, like, text me, or they'll call me up, and I'll be like, they'll call me Kat, and I'll be like, oh, wait, oh.
Oh.
Okay.
Oh, yeah, you know
really
me
not,
as that.
I know them in real life, and I make the, like, the real-life physical person connection with my real name, and then, like, just voices, like, on the internet. Like, it's weird to know that people that are physical beings that I have touched in real life and seen in real life call
Where did
me
you
Kat.
Touch you?
You're touching a lot of people, Kat? I feel like this is,
I just had one of those, like, really deep emotional moments where you just put your hand on their shoulder and you just... You know,
you just
kind of sigh together.
Yeah, you just, like, stare into their eyes, don't say a single word, and then awkwardly walk away. Like, one of those.
Exactly.
Yeah,
okay. I had a lot of those moments at camp. Mostly because I was in pain, because I hate being at camp.
Yeah, camp.
Mm-hmm.
I just put my hand on the shoulder, and was like, I don't want to be here. I just walk.
I don't want to be here, as you look them in the eyes.
Yeah. I did meet some cool people there, and I don't really talk to them anymore. I follow them on Instagram, where, you know, we're mutuals. It's pretty cool, but I don't like, I don't like camps.
Just gonna throw this out there, my name's back on the top.
yep, because Steve is getting all everyone's admin powers back.
He didn't give me server admin, though, so I'm a little upset.
For those at audience, we had to do a server reset, so that was fun.
Yeah, I noticed. There was, like, a weird pop-up thing when I joined.
Yeah.
Yeah, it was an issue, yeah. It was an issue for a little bit. Everything's cool now. But sorry, Kat, continue with
your... No, I was just agreeing.
You were talking about your camp of summer.
No, I finished.
You're finished. Well, you don't want to talk more about how you deeply looked in people's eyes and said, I don't want to be here, and I don't want to spend any time with you because you fucking suck and walk
just
away.
That's just about it. You said it again.
Hit the nail on the head.
No, you know, so just to reiterate. No, I'm kidding, I'm not doing that again.
I mean, I can explain why I don't like being at summer camps if that's a topic that we all want to discuss for some reason. How about it becomes a question? Do you guys like summer camps?
I've never been, and I feel like the answer would be no, because I love the internet.
I worked there for 3 years, and the only reason why I quit was because administration was horrible.
Oh yeah, that tends to be a thing. this guy I met, he was a dishwasher there, and I think he got paid like under minimum
Server
wage.
Group assigned.
It was a job, so he took it. Yeah, so, I don't know if they're underpaid, but, like, they're getting fed. They get to live in, like, the cabins and stuff, and you get, like...
Yeah, that's how they get away with paying you below minimum wage is...
Yeah, man!
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I used to work in a drug rehab for a little while, but they paid us, like, under minimum, but we had... room and board, and we had, or not room and board, but we had a place to stay, and then we had, free meals, too. Mm-hmm. They paid us, like, $5 an hour.
But, so that's both really cool and really sucky, because, like, you can't screw up, because you have now lost your place to live.
Yes.
It's like, you don't just get fired, you also lose your home. that sucks. But, like, I guess that would be, like, a good way to make sure all of your, your employees are, like, really caring.
Yeah.
That's a good idea.
You have to make sure that they're really good employees and not just hire a bunch of
idiots. I mean, you didn't have to live there, but you could.
Yeah.
Would you have been paid more if you didn't live there?
I don't know, to be honest. I wasn't there long enough to really know.
True that. I feel like you'd have to be, right? Because if they're not giving you room and board... How would they pay you,
I think so.
Like, less than minimum wage?
Yeah. There's also a lot of fudging of the hours, too, because you'd end up working, like, 16-hour days and then only be able to claim, like, 8. So it was pretty shitty.
Yeah. That's no bueno, man.
No.
No.
My summer camp wasn't, like, that bad. We did get 8 below minimum wage, but you got a raise every consecutive year you worked there.
How many years in a row did you work there?
3.
Oh, that's 3 raises. Or 2.
Yeah, no.
Let's go.
Yeah, it's 2 raises. I started out at, like, just... I think it was, like, $1,400 for the summer. And then, by the end of it, I got, like... $2,300, maybe, for the summer?
That's not bad at all, dude.
I just got pissed because the reason why I quit was I was the most eligible for a, Hi, Tony.
Yeah, hi.
Okay. I was the most eligible for an assistant manager position because I'd worked there for 3 years straight. And they decided to give it to... Okay, one, you had to be 18 to get the position.
Mm-hmm.
So, first they offered it to a guy who would be 18, had 2 years of experience, but was caught cursing in front of the campers a lot. Which, considering we dealt with 11-year-olds, was not okay. And
yeah.
Really just because the manager liked him more.
I would have not been able to work there.
And the guy... the guy turned down the assistant manager position. I'm like, okay, it'll be me next, because I'm definitely, like, the next best. And then they gave it to someone who would be underage and had only worked there for a year. And then the manager says, Mark, I know you applied, but, you know, maybe next year... And I literally said, there's not going to be a next year. Goodbye. And I just left.
That's how we do. Yeah, screw
it. It was the end of the summer, and I'm like, I always got, like, at least, like, 4 out of 5 stars because the parents would, like, rate the counselors.
Yeah.
I always, like, averaged, like, 4 out of 5 stars. So, like, good counselor. I had the most experience.
And they didn't
and
get
I never had any
screw
complaints.
Them, dude.
And They're just like, yeah, no, we like these other 2 people better.
I even think Mark
they have less experience.
You've been a lot better than any of them, dude.
I don't really care anymore, I mean.
No, I'm just saying, I'm angry at them. Let's find them. I want to find them and, or send them a link to this podcast and tell them they're stupid.
I mean, the last summer I worked there was, like, summer of junior year?
Yeah, summer of junior year. I would say that, yeah, definitely. Because I think as soon as, like, we became really good friends, you didn't work there anymore.
Let's see.
I think it just happened to work like that, right?
It was summer of junior year, definitely, because I remember there was a lot of drama going on at the friend group at the time, and I remember being at the summer camp, hearing about the drama, and I'm like, oh,
This is awkward. I can't.
So yeah, it was definitely summer of junior year.
Yeah. That was your last one?
That was my last one, yeah. I worked there summer of freshman year, summer of sophomore year, and then summer of junior year.
Okay.
Cool.
Yeah.
Yay.
Woo, working, you know, working experience, you know.
Yeah.
You know, it's pretty cool. Oh, so by the way, Kat's on the podcast.
I am.
So she's here now. Yeah, she came in. Yeah. Just on time. You know, on time, like always.
Uh-huh.
So
as always.
So, I think actually right now is a terrific time to play What Did Kat Have for Dinner, and I'm guessing mac and cheese.
Solid. Okay.
Wait, what?
Make hot dogs.
I'm guessing mac and cheese.
You know what she had for dinner, didn't
no.
you?
No, I do know a little bit of information,
I
though.
I gave a little bit of a hint pre-podcast because I had to explain why I was going to be here late.
Yep.
I was here late because my parents aren't home. They're out to dinner, your Mother's Day kind of thing. Not to the cinema as well. So I am here
with
my sister, so I had to make dinner. There's the hint.
Chicken nuggets, that's my guess.
Ooh, that's a good
that's
one.
Actually good. Because like, you got to keep in mind, it's not just for her, it's also for a younging. little toddler. No, maybe
she's
not toddler.
She's actually 12.
You know, so not teenager, so child.
Yeah,
just
yeah.
Throwing that out there.
Yeah,
math.
So a 12-year-old toddler.
But Kat, how old were you when you were 12?
That's a real question.
You, where, Mark, you were on for that episode, right?
Yeah, I'm on for that episode. How old was I when I was 12?
Oh, that's great. That's one of my favorite quotes of all time, Kat. Like, Kat, the fact that you
I
said
still
that
think about
and
it.
Meant it.
I still think about it to this day.
That's great.
Probably one of the best podcast quotes I've heard, but I still think the best, like, quote I've heard from one of our friends is, "Where do you guys get the memes?"
Oh, yeah. I don't want to talk about the situation where that happened in.
Yeah, no.
But, like, we fun. that those details can remain bleak, but our friend Mike... What just looked at us like completely serious and goes, "Where do you guys get the memes?" And we're like, "What?" He was dead serious. Like, he was so serious.
He was just. He wasn't playing.
No, he was serious.
He was serious.
He was serious. Cause, and we're like, what do you say when someone.
Where do you guys get the memes?
It's like,
What do you mean?
What do you mean? Where do you get the memes? It's like, what? I don't know what to say to you, man. Like,
I don't know.
I'm just gonna laugh at you. That's what we did. We laughed at him.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Sounds like a great time.
I think actually, immediately he said it, we probably all like died immediately. This
I have some pretty great quotes from me and my friend Anna, and I think Zach was in a few of them too, my other friend.
Good old Zach, am I right?
I need to find my quotes.
Do you have like a tab like on Google Drive that says my quotes?
I have
my
okay,
friend's
I have
quotes
a sticky
here.
Note kind of thing.
I mean,
in my
I
phone.
Have something like that, but I have a list of all my friends' cars in my phone.
Do you really?
Yeah.
Oh, I remember that. Yeah, actually.
Yeah, because I just wanted to make sure that, like, if I needed to, like, help you guys with something, I had, like, all the car details, so it's, like, year, make, model. So it's, like, I have all my close friends, like, cars in my phone, just that if
oh, God.
They ever, like, ask for advice, I can quickly be, like, okay, wait, what was it? Like, oh, right, that, okay.
You could be, like, oh, I think you should do this, and it works. It's, like, whoa, how did you know that? I'm just good at cars. Not that I had all the information ready to go, if you ever asked.
Yeah, I have, like, basic things like, Tony, for your car, I have the amount of oil it takes, what type of oil, and the exact, number for your, oil filter.
Ooh, that's cool.
It's just so that it's, like, if you ever want to do it by yourself, it's like, oh yeah, pick up this, and this. Yeah, there you go.
Wow, okay. You know, I accept this knowledge that you have, you know. It's not like a weird knowledge either. There's some things
I mean, I'm the car guy of the group.
Yeah,
so
it's expected, yeah. Yeah.
Yeah.
Damn, very expected.
So, on the topic of, like, funny quotes and things like that, there's this great time in, like, pre-chem class, okay? So we have chemistry, but, like, it takes 10 minutes for that class to get started, so we're all just talking for 5 to 10 minutes before the class starts. So, you know, me, Zach, and Anna are chilling over by your table, and, so Anna was looking particularly adorable that day, even though she refuses, she looks adorable. So I was like, Anna, how do you actually not have a boyfriend? You're totally cute. And then Zach interjects and he says, she eats them. And just, that was it. First out laughing, because that is such an Anna thing. I wouldn't doubt it if she actually eats her boyfriend.
You know, so just throwing this out there for any guys watching the podcast and people in the podcast, if you meet someone named Anna, run.
Yeah.
They might
eat. She's also a massive weeaboo, so...
Double run.
I mean,
but what a weeb!
She's about the weeaboo equivalent of me, and, like, it's a really light term. We don't mean it in, like, the insulting kind of way, where, like, we're, like, totally, like, Japan is better than America. Like, no, that's not how we are. We just really like anime and things. So,
fucking weird.
But she did recently start watching Naruto, and she's 40 episodes in. And it's been,
the original,
like,
one, or?
Yeah, the original Naruto. So,
I watched that when I was, like, 12, I think.
Yeah. I mean, she is just starting it, and she really likes it, so. It's pretty neat.
It's so I would just like to take a moment for any of the weeaboos watching that in, like, the Shippuden, I think that's the second one, right? Naruto's kids are called named Burrito and Salad.
You mean Boruto?
Yeah, Burrito.
Yeah, yeah. It's meant to be bulked.
It's a burrito.
Boruto
and Salad.
So, Hydra, do you have any topics for today?
What do you think I am, like, the host of this?
Yeah.
Oh, shit, you're right. Huh. So I think it's a good time, so pre-podcast, we were going to call someone out on something.
Oh, no.
That guy being Mark.
No.
I don't know. You got to fill me in on
this. No.
Jordan, Derek, is this a good time to do this?
I don't know what we're talking about. Was I here for this conversation?
Yeah, you were. How do I tell you this without, like, giving the topic away? His dating history.
But that doesn't make any sense at all.
Mark's dating history?
Oh, yeah, so, Mark.
There we go.
I swear to God, Derek.
So, can we talk about your Rachel fetish for just a... second.
Yeah, this is something we gotta talk about.
I wasn't here for this, I swear to God.
Were you not here? I'm pretty sure you're here,
Jordan. I have no idea what you guys are talking about.
But I think it's, like, a serious problem we need to address, Mark. Just, like...
What?
Mark is a Rachel.
It's not me, I know, but... You need to fill me in.
Yeah, okay. You know, so... As the host of this show, I think it's a great idea for me to tell this story.
It's, like, associated with, like, antisocial personality disorder. It's, like, really, really serious.
I need to know this. I'm so confused. It's
one of the weirdest fetishes, though, I've ever heard of. Like, Derek. People with the name Rachel. Like, it's kind of, like...
And this is at the point where if we were to talk in real life, I would slowly back away from Mark.
Okay, it's not as weird as you think. It's just...
Oh, no, yeah, it's much weirder.
So please explain!
Mark just telling a kid.
Okay, so I've had three girlfriends, and all three girlfriends have been named Rachel. Mm-hmm. That's it.
Yeah, so I can, for 100% fact... This is a stat. 100% of girls that Mark has dated have been named Rachel.
Mm-hmm.
That's interesting. It's kind of like an abundance of Catherines, in a way.
Yeah, like, well, the video game, Catherine. Like, the Catherine McKay for Catherine
McKay. Don't you, Derek, like, to word it as in, I have a Rachel fetish.
You know, but... I never said those words.
Tony.
Yeah, you did.
No, I didn't say fetish. So, I said, a thing.
So
different.
My defense is that I've asked out other girls, but Rachel's are the only ones who have said yes. Not my fault.
You need to make sure that you date R-A-C-H-A-E-Ls, not R-A-C-H-E-Ls, because Rachels are bitches most of the time. Excuse my language. I know.
Hey, guys, is this a bad time to tell you the one he's dating now is EO?
Well, speaking from experience,
here we go. Oh, wait a second. Actually, I'm gonna agree with Mark right here because at least when it comes to Mark, because I can't, it's the only experience I have in this matter. The AEL was a huge bitch, and the E and the one.
I know that one. I know she was not so cool, but speaking as an AEL.
As an AEL.
I know. I tend to think that the ones that are just ELs have like a really different personality than AELs because I know lots of AELs. Most of the time, they're pretty down to earth, and they're pretty respectful. But the ELs, those ones, are like, I'm Rachel number one. I'm cooler than you.
Did we just break up some sort of inner hatred in Kat?
On how her name is spelled.
What the fuck? Whoa, time out! I'm calling you out, Mark.
What do you mean?
Your logic.
I don't know what you're talking about.
There's been so many times where you said that markers for K's are way better than markers for C's. You have an opinion on how your name's spelled.
But I revised that due to certain recent circumstances.
I haven't heard you say it.
I think I have a good say here. People who spell Derek D-E-R-R-I-C-K are retarded.
Yeah, actually, I've seen that spelled like that, and I don't know why.
It's just makes no sense. Like, why?
I knew.
To be fair, I've had a really... I told someone my name is Mark with a K, and they thought I meant M-A-R-C-K.
Oh.
And I'm like, no, that's stupid.
That's so stupid! Why would you ever think that? Dude, if I was there, I would have told that person you're so dumb.
It was so bad. It's like, oh, so you mean M-A-R-C-K? That's a cool way to spell it. No.
What?
No.
Are you autistic? That. What?
That's what I would have said.
But, I mean, the reason I got so angry about the AEL thing is...
Have you had a bad run-in with AELs?
This is like...
No, AELs?
What are those, like, elementary school kind of things that, like, you hold this unreasonable grudge against someone from elementary school for absolutely no logical reason.
This is great. I need to hear this.
I've known multiple RACHELs from my old school, and all of them include... There's this one. All right, so, little bit of a backstory. How many of you have had... those girls in your class that are obsessed with horses.
By a show of hands.
There's always one girl in your class that is obsessed with horses.
I actually know exactly what you're talking about.
No, I know what she's talking
like,
about.
Every There's always grade one. Has one of these girls, and they're just like totally head over heels for horses. They just love them. They have like horse everything.
Yeah, it's a thing.
Because I was completely antisocial.
That's probably
That might be. But if, I mean, even if you looked around, you'd be able to tell because they have like horseshoe hair thing.
I almost have, Mark. Like, I guarantee there was one. I guarantee.
Oh, and there, emails are like a question girl 66 at hotmail.com.
Exactly.
Anyway, there's this one in my class right now. Her name's Kaylee, and she's adorable. I love her, and I really don't have very much against her because she's a sweet girl. But she's the horse girl of our grade.
The horse girl.
she has like a bracelet with her horse's name on it. It's really sweet.
Oh, she owns a horse and everything.
Yeah, I don't know if they're like her horses.
Oh, but
she rides
them.
But yeah, and she likes horses. She really likes horses, but she's not like obsessed. But I'm pretty sure her Instagram handle is like Kaylee Horses Obsessed or something.
I would say she's obsessed with horses, just by the username. Yeah. Right?
If you asked her, do you like horses? She'd be like, yeah, I like horses. Because she's pretty toned down about that kind of thing. But if you ask me if I like cats, I'd be like, cats are goddesses. So, I mean...
I still think dogs are better creatures than cats.
I come across as more obsessed, but she comes down as more mellow, even though her passion for horses is probably stronger than mine for cats. I don't know. Actually, I don't know about that.
That's a strong statement.
That is a really strong statement. As soon as I said it, I was like,
wait. You're like, wait, no. I don't know about that one.
Anyway, about this RACHEL... girl. Throughout, I think it was like fourth grade through sixth grade, I had her in my class, but mainly it was fourth grade, I'm pretty sure. I was going to say her last name, but
no, go ahead.
It was Rachel.
Go ahead.
Rachel R.
What is it going to say?
If you're listening to this.
And where does she live?
I kind of still hate you.
What's her last name?
I can't say her. I don't
and
know.
What's her phone number?
What's her name, her phone number, her address, social security number. I'm gonna say hair color, eye color. It doesn't matter to me, but to someone it will.
Height.
Okay. Blonde hair, brown hair, and what?
Opposite of me, pretty much, because I have blonde hair and blue eyes. So like we were opposites almost. Anyway.
Okay, I'm not writing this down to give to Hitman.
I have had such a like.
Here you
I
go,
Mark. Such a grudge over her for so Thank many you. Years. Because in kindergarten.
Now send it to her.
In kindergarten. This is a really important story.
So I'm is that.
Apart, I'm tearing apart my
And what does she smell like?
Lilacs.
She probably smells like horses.
Oh, she smells like horses.
Anyway.
The horses
in
smoke
kindergarten, I was a good kid, and I had a lot of friends. My entire class was my friend. So, what I did for her...
You remember this in kindergarten?
Yes!
How do you have that vivid memories of kindergarten?
So, I, being a good friend, made her a picture. I drew her a picture of a horse, and I gave it to her. And do you know what she did with it?
Ripped it up.
She ripped it up!
She did! What a cunt.
Freaking! I spent hours on that, and I gave it to her because I was her good friend, and she ripped it up, and I felt.
Why
so
do you know why she ripped it up?
She was later, actually, in a later grade. I spoke to her about this because I'm an assertive person. I was like, "Why did you do that to me?" So this was like fifth grade or something. I was like, "Why did you do that to me?" And she said, I don't know. She was really humble about it. She was like, "I was jealous or something."
I was jealous of the way you drew the horses, so I ripped it up.
I mean,
wow, that's a very constructive.
And then later in fifth
grade...
Oh,
this is kindergarten, though.
Yeah, that was kindergarten. But later in fifth grade, there was this whole thing is why I still hate her today. I mean, I understand that she was in kindergarten. I'm going over that a little bit.
I don't think you're over it at all, Kat.
This is what got me. We were in class, you know, and I was not the coolest kid in 5th to 6th grade. I still am not, even though I'm in 10th grade now.
Another film.
But I was really uncool in 5th grade, 6th grade, and my entire class, like, there were a couple duplicates of kids, like, not the same kid, obviously, but kids with the same name.
I was gonna say,
so
like,
there were,
twins?
Like, two Marks and two Rachels and two Jordans or whatever it is.
Nice.
Woo.
Anyway, so they would always decide which one was Jordan number one and Jordan number two.
Oh my god, that sounds so familiar.
Or Mark number one and Mark number two, and Rachel number one and Rachel number two. And I would always be Rachel number two, and I felt really bad about this because I was not the coolest kid. I had my friends, of course.
Sounds
but, like,
traumatizing.
It was really traumatizing because this was like in front of the entire class. It was like one of those weird class discussions. I don't know why. It was like before you started class, everyone would be discussing this, you know, so the teacher wasn't there or something. So we'd be discussing this, and we'd all like collectively decide as a group which one was Rachel number one and which one was Rachel number two. And I felt really sad because she was like, I'm Rachel number one. And I'm like, why? Why?
I'm going to put a hole in your upset logic.
Yeah, okay.
Rachel number two is a greater number than one. Mm-hmm. So, you were greater.
It is also the number.
Yeah, but like, I mean, I tried to establish.
Jordy, not helping.
I tried.
I'm an engineer.
Okay.
Two is twice as great as one.
Oh,
he's an engineer. You have to trust everything he says.
Mm-hmm. Clearly.
There's some math.
But
that's an engineer that did that. You need to trust a kid.
Mm-hmm. And being like the sweet little kid I was, I tried to like equal it out, being like, why do we have to choose number one and number two? We're both Rachel. What does it matter? Like, you know, this is really uncomfortable. Why do you have to just single me out like this? Isn't that cool? Like, and I tried to. Eventually, I gave up on that, and I like tried to say like, well, two's greater than one, something like that. I don't know, something similar. And then, like, it was really sad because she was, like, a really dominant and assertive kind of bully sort of person.
Nice.
And she was really mean to me, and Jordan's I did not like girl. It. And
yeah, that's all right.
And later, I've met more Rachels in my lifetime. Most of the time, the ELs tend to be a little bit conceited, and the AELs tend to be a little bit more dorky. And, like, you know, I identify with that.
That's what, I forgot this word and we were still on. I forgot we were still talking about the Rachel spelling.
How, which way Rachel is spelled and which way is better.
Uh-huh. Yeah. I mean, I tend to think that, like, this is kind of a relevant thing, like, the way that your name is spelled. What your name is actually kind of reflects your personality. Like, Brittany's are considerably, most of the time, like,
retarded.
Bitches. Like, you can kind of tell that. We know a couple Britneys. I know a couple Britneys. Most of the time, they're not so nice. But then, like, I don't know, what's a really nice name?
Shans.
Sure.
Yeah, sure.
I just say I'm that because I know...
There's a 50-50 chance that he's a power bottom.
There we go. No, but Hydra, you know a gay person named Chance, right?
What up?
You know a gay person named Chance too, right?
Oh, okay, so it's actually DJ's, like DJ Blue Jay's brother's boyfriend is also a gay Chance.
Oh, wow.
There's two of them.
That's great.
So 100% of Chances we know are gay.
This is true.
Or dogs.
Oh.
Really,
dog
oh. I know a dog named Chance. They're gay.
You should ask the dog.
Gay.
Well,
I would,
well,
but I can't talk to dogs, unfortunately.
In obvious defense of my girlfriend, Antonia can tell you that she is not, like...
A dog?
The horrible.
She's not a dog either, can confirm.
I mean, obviously you can't take it. It's kind of like the Zodiac thing that I was talking yesterday. Like, you can't obviously take this into consideration completely. This is what I know from experience, and you can obviously take it differently. But, like, you know, it's just, you know, chill. It's chill. Chill. So, I mean, Rachel's are obviously gonna be different because they're different people. So.
Okay,
yeah.
So, Mark, I'm just gonna throw this out there. I just Snapchatted your girlfriend asking, does she have an opinion on the way her name's spelled?
She actually does.
Oh, God! I need to hear...
She thinks AEL is a very stupid way to spell.
Let's go!
Let's go.
I didn't choose it. My parents, actually. Right,
exactly! So you can't judge other people for being named Rachel E.L.
Because they didn't pick it, Kat.
Mm-hmm.
Or should I say Rachel? Dun,
but
dun,
listen,
dun.
Well, no, we should be...
Listen, guys, this is a serious story a little bit. It's kind of interesting to know. So when my mom was pregnant with me, she told me, like, she's told me this story, that I told her that my name was Rachel. And, like, she'd be like, okay, well, you know, like, this was on a spiritual level, you know, I was, like, inside her stomach, uterus,
whoa.
You know, so, like, it was on a spiritual mother-daughter kind of baby level, like, this was not...
So did you, like, come to her, like, in a dream and said, hello, future mother, my name is Rachel, and you better name me that, or there will be consequences, and then, like, you faded into darkness and, like, left, like, a black rose...
No, I'm imagining more of it like a mafia shakedown. That's it's a very nice house you have. It'd be a shame if something were to happen to it. Got peach.
But my mom, she's told me that, like, I've asked her, like, how, like, why'd you name me Rachel? Like, why? Like, what would I be named if I wasn't named Rachel? But my mom always tells me that my name is Rachel because... When she was pregnant with me, I told her that my name was Rachel. And so she'd like, go through baby books or something, and she'd be like, well, how about this name? Or how about this name? But I would be like, no.
Did you verbally say no? Because that's quite weird. I'm just going to throw that out there. That's not normal for a pregnancy. I'm just going to throw that out there.
What?
When going through a baby book, and if you actually verbally said no from inside your mother, that would be quite terrifying.
My mom is a kind of spiritual person in the sense that, not necessarily, like, religious, but, like, she believes in reincarnation pretty strongly, and she's had, like, experiences in her life that makes her believe in this kind of thing. So, like, this is a lot of, like, really, connective kind of stuff. Sorry, my sister's like playing Minecraft or something. Katrina, can you please hush? I'm trying to tell a very serious and emotional story.
Punch her in the mouth.
Don't worry, trust.
But, like, my mom has a lot of these, like, sort of, like, moment kind of things, and, like, it's really, like, I don't know how else to say it other than spiritual. She'd probably be able to explain it to you better than I would. But, like, you know, she has these experiences and things, and it's really interesting to listen to. Especially, like, from her, the primary source, you know, instead of me.
Secondary source.
But it's pretty interesting to hear, and I don't know why I chose the name Rachel.
Did you, have you ever asked her, like, did you choose the spelling, or did she choose the spelling?
I think I probably have. I don't remember that, but I think that's what, I don't know, maybe it was, like, a group thing.
Did you choose the extra letter? Did you say that this amount of letters is not good enough for me?
I think she chose, it might have been a her thing, but it might have also been, like, my decision as well, as a soul inside of her stomach.
Okay.
Can I interject for a second?
No. Yeah, of course you can.
I think my mom is the reason why I looked down on the name Mark with a C, because apparently when she was pregnant, my dad and her were going through, like, a baby book name, like a baby book name thing, and she's like, oh, how about Marcus? And she looks and she's like, nah, I don't like the way that's spelled. And my older sister went, how about Mark with a K? And that was how I got it. So my mom literally saw the name Marcus spelled with a C and was like, that looks stupid.
Named me Mark. And then your older sister, who was a small child at the time, was like, what about with K? I like it, kid. You've got like good intentions, kid. Going with you.
And it's not Marcus, it's just Mark for me. It's just M-A-R-K. No full name, that is my full name.
Yeah, I know, like, right, have people ask you all the time, like, if it's short for something, right?
Yeah, like they do. It's like, nah, it's just Mark, M-A-R-K, that's it.
Yeah,
okay, Kat, continue, my bad.
Yeah, go ahead, continue your rampage on destroying ELs, yeah. And defending AELs.
I'm trying to look up, like, not really definition, but the
like what your name means. Okay, so
I'm pretty sure Rachel with an EL versus Rachel with an AEL mean different things. So I'm looking that up right now.
Is this like Zodiac symbols 2.0? Are we gonna have this again? Is this gonna happen again? Someone might have an answer.
So Jordan, Derek, what are you guessing for what did Kat have for dinner? Because we never answered that.
Oh yeah.
Oh, I'll go spaghetti.
Wait, what is it?
Wow. Good job, Mark.
Oh my.
That's why I was a host for a while.
Yeah. Look at that.
Before we go on to this, like, on the topic of names, before we leave, it kind of sucks because, like, you know, Rachel is spelled, my name is spelled weird, so, like, you know, this actually pertains to other Rachels, you know. I just kind of went on a weird tangent there. I'll be in the hallway, and someone will be like, hey, Michael! And I will mishear it, and hear it as Rachel, because they're pronounced, like, the same way. And I'll turn around, and they'll be like, wait, why did you just turn around, go back, go away.
So, don't you turn around, turn it back around.
On the stairs. Someone was, like, directly behind me, and then they went, like, Michael! And I was zoned out, and so I heard it as Rachel. And I turned around, and they were like, who are you? What are you doing? Turn around!
Who are you?
It was such an awkward situation.
Don't you know Kat's a 12-year-old boy?
I am.
Makes sense. Yep.
Needs to make sense. Alright, so I guess mac and cheese. I actually think Derek yelled hot dogs.
Derek! Okay, we'll just assign that as his guess.
I'm just gonna...
Okay. Jordan gets spaghetti and I guess chicken nuggets.
Okay. Alright. We need Jordan to come back.
Jordan!
I'm back.
Hi.
Okay. Did you guess hot dogs?
No, Derek guessed hot dogs.
Oh, Derek. We need Derek to come back. Sorry, I misheard the name.
Oh my god, if it's hot dogs, I'm actually gonna kill a baby.
We need him to come back.
That's it.
Oh, he just went away on Steam.
Someone find me a baby.
Although we do need to ask him, can he confirm that that's his guess?
I don't know. I don't think that actually... I don't know.
I think he just asked, why didn't Tony guess?
He did. Oh, okay.
Well, he said, oh, now I can pick hot dogs.
No,
you know, I'm actually...
All of your guesses are final.
Yeah, all of our guesses are final. And I'm going to say that, Derek, you have 5 seconds to name your guess. If you do not name your guess, you have been barred from the competition. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, ding, ding. Unfortunately, Derek has been disqualified from the competition.
Okay.
Now,
so
what did you have for dinner?
I had hot dogs and macaroni and cheese.
Wait.
What?
Wait a second.
Was going to be a 50-50.
So I still won.
You still won.
I'm the best!
Oh, man.
I don't guess hot dogs, I still win!
Yeah.
This is my game, people.
I was hoping that somebody else was going to guess hot dogs, too. You said macaroni and cheese, I was like, oh, no. But, I knew it was going to be interesting either way, because I did have macaroni and cheese, but I also had hot dogs.
It's a great day.
So.
Great day. Good job. Good job, Hydro. High five.
Derek lost his
option. Take that, Derek! That's what you get for walking away, probably to eat pizza or something. Because he's probably really hungry and gave up.
Mm-hmm. So do we have any topics? Because I've gone on a lot of rants tonight.
Oh, yeah.
Sorry about that. I'm really bad at getting to my point, audience. I'm really sorry.
Yeah,
about
audience,
that.
you should not be
angry. For some
angry.
Reason lately, just my mind has been all over the place when I'm telling stories, so it makes it really non-linear and kind of hard to follow and really boring. So I'm sorry about that.
There is two of the topics I want to talk about. I need Derek here for.
Okay.
No, actually, I didn't do car talk because one of them is a clip of something that happened in CS today that's just freaking hilarious
what
and very awkward. Okay, so I'll just explain it. Summit was playing for Splice today. And Splice was up 15-12 on Train. Summit is in a 1v1, gets the kill, has plenty of time to defuse. The camera pans away from him, says that Splice has won the match 16-12, then looks back at the screen and Summit's dead.
Oh.
He killed himself in a Molotov after clutching the round.
Oh,
and
God.
Lost. Splice lost the map and lost the series 2-0.
Oh, like he killed himself on purpose?
No, not on purpose. You know how, on, a LAN or something, you get to kill and then go for, high fives to your teammates? He was looking away from his screen and, going forward and walked into a Molotov.
Oh, no.
It was the saddest thing ever, and he lost.
That's so bad.
He lost.
Oh, that's so bad.
Right?
I bet he wants to kill himself.
Yeah, honestly, because he was just talking about how, he decided not to go pro. And he got to go, to a LAN. He was like, yeah, I'll show everyone I could do it. And he makes possibly the biggest mistake in CS history. Oof. It was so cringy. Because they lost 2-0 because of that. They would have won up. They could have, won the series.
Oh, yeah.
Oof, that was bad.
Yeah, that's fucked.
He still is richer than any of us will ever be, though, so. Yeah. He can't feel that bad, I guess.
No.
I do have a few topics. I do have, you know what? I'll pitch this idea, and then when he comes back, I'll say it to him. So you know how I want to do Backward Noise 10-man?
Yeah.
This is an idea.
What is this?
A Backward Noise 10-man from CS:GO. It would be 10 people from Backward Noise and just playing a match of CS. And I had an idea. I feel like I'm going to abstain from the match. And, shoutcast it.
Okay.
I'm going to shoutcast it. And then I decided I need 2 people, to be captains on teams. And I think it would be a really interesting idea. What if I put Chance and Derek as the captains?
Oh.
That'd be
pretty
neat.
That would be a good idea.
Right? I think it would be so great. Because, they already butt heads. But this actually might make them both try really hard.
I'm in.
I'm down.
Let's go.
I'll be right back. I need to get some drink.
But, right? Like, I think this is the idea. And then, like, I was trying to, in my head, I had an idea. I'm going to have them 1v1, and whoever wins gets the first pick. So basically, whoever wins gets Jordan on their team. Because, like, the only people I have, like, who said they'd do it so far are it's Chance, Derek, you, Jordan, Kyle, Chris, and Mark.
Oh, yeah.
So, if they win and don't pick you, that's really stupid. Because, there's not really anyone else, like, that good
that plays a lot.
Who could play. Like, who've been on background. It's like, we have people we know who would be really good players. But I'm trying to think of background.
Do I have to play?
No, you don't have to.
Okay, because I suck, so.
If you want to play, you can play, though.
I mean, I don't want to hurt anybody's team. This happens all the time in gym class. Like, I call
that's the best thing you've
ever seen. Yeah, that's.
What did I say?
That was beautiful.
It was just so honestly
sad. Yeah, it was.
I mean, like, you know, like, we don't have the things in high school, you know, where there's two team captains and they select people from the pool of kids and, you know, picked last. That did happen to me a couple times, though. When it did happen, but it's very rare because the teachers don't like it because it's mean. But I'm usually picked around last when that does happen.
You know, anyway, I was never picked last, so happy.
I mean, you are a guy, so typically guys tend to be a little bit more
active. No, see, the way my elementary school picked was, like, you had to pick, like, girl first and then boy first. Mm-hmm. So, like, there was a good shot that, like, if you weren't, like, the most athletic kid, you'd get picked last.
Mm-hmm.
When I was a lot younger, I was picked very close to last, if not last, actually, all the time. But once, because I was, like, a really short, fat kid. Like, it was true, like, I couldn't grow, and I was just fucking, like, 140 pounds. It was the saddest thing.
I just had no muscle back then, so I was really scrawny.
Better than short, fat kid.
Scrawny.
At least you could probably run.
Depends on the sport.
You could run.
No, honestly, the guys with more weight were usually picked first for, like, football.
Well, yeah, that's football.
We
though.
Actually did, like, tackle football.
We don't even have football in our school because our school is so freaking small. We don't have a football team. We don't usually play it in gym class.
Oh, so I just want to throw this out there real quick. Derek went to McDonald's. He just really? Left and went to McDonald's.
Did he Snapchat?
Yeah, he did.
Oh my.
He Snapchatted me, I caved. So during one of our conversations, he just left.
That's great.
That's great. That's great. But
anyway, about the gym class thing. Anyway, like, I really don't put a lot of effort into gym class. I think I have, like, the ability to play. I'm not very good at sports themselves. I'm a pretty active person, but I don't, like, play sports regularly. I know the rules, I'm just not very good at it. I'm not very good at, like, going one-on-one with someone in soccer, like, fighting for the ball and, like, all this stuff. I'm not very good at sports. So, if you're bad at sports and you're playing in gym class with people that are good at sports, you will never get the opportunity to improve because the people who are good hog the game. And you don't have these opportunities to play and get better. So you just kind of continuously suck at the game.
You could totally practice at home.
I mean, you could do that. It's kind of like, what's the point? It's not fun anyway. Like, I don't really care
what
about
sports,
so.
What you need to do is start doing a lot of steroids.
That's a good idea.
Crystal meth. Right
or now. Both.
I mean, with our school, we always had, like, opportunities, kind of. Because, like, we did a lot of, like, recreational stuff, like the volleyball games, don't
we? Yeah.
Or, like, we had recreational basketball games, too.
Exactly.
So it was just, like,
there were opportunities to shine.
Yeah. I mean, but at this point in time, I'm in 10th grade. So the people that are good at sports are always, like, pretty much going to stay good at sports. And the people who aren't good at sports don't really have a place where they can get good at sports. Because if you join a sport team, it's kind of that same situation where if you suck, you stay sucking because you don't have the same opportunity. Because, like, if you're in a soccer game, for example, and you suck at the game, and you're trying to play as much as you can, but your teammates will not pass the ball to you because you suck and you screw up, you won't move.
That is true. That is true. I mean, like, I know you're talking about gym, me. But, like, to get better at anything, just have to practice. It doesn't matter what it is.
I mean, I could practice, but, like, it's just gym class.
That's true. In this example, you don't really have to care because it's gym class. But, like, getting better at anything, just have to practice. Doesn't matter what it is.
It's not like you're out for a sport. No. So it's a big difference.
Or you take, like, Counter-Strike really seriously, like I do and Jordan does and Derek does.
Yeah, back on the Counter-Strike topic. I guess I would like to get good at Counter-Strike. I would do it if I had, like, the time and I had the effort.
The effort is a huge part, yeah.
Because, I mean, I know that a lot of people get really salty about it, and if I'm going to do something, I don't want to have that negativity about it.
Don't play it. Whatever you do, do not play your chance.
Yeah. Or actually Counter-Strike at all.
Yeah. Right? Yeah, actually, yeah.
Mm-hmm. And Counter-Strike is one good, of those things. So join me.
Go on.
I'm trying to get good.
Exactly. So over this summer, I'm going to be smurfing a lot. And playing with, like, a bunch of people. So if you guys want to join, hop in, you know?
I might do it in the summertime because that means I will have time. But, like, in school days, like, I don't always have time afternoons because I have a lot of homework and I have, like, other things to do at my Etsy shop to keep up, things like that. So to play Counter-Strike and have, plus having that negativity in your life because of the Counter-Strike, it's, like, a little bit too much right now. But in the summertime, if I'm able to handle it, I have a lot of time, you know, it's a different story. So
you learn to let it not affect you after a while. There's a guy in our game at DMG who only used the P90.
Oh, yeah, that was bad.
Was he good with it?
No.
That's not good.
I know who we're talking about, I think. No,
we just played with them once.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Carrot's not a DMG.
Okay.
Carrot's fucking horrible.
Okay, you literally told me, you didn't tell me what rank you
said. I said DMG.
Carried all the way up.
Oh, no, I said DMG.
I mean Carrot's rank.
Oh,
You never told me what Carrot's rank. You just told me you carried him to a rank that he's way too
He did high get DMG, but that was old DMG and didn't need anything.
See? I could be confused. Ha.
Yeah, but I've told you Carrot's like a Nova 2.
Yeah, I know.
But yeah, Carrot's one of, honestly speaking, Carrot is, like, I've said this on multiple podcasts before, and I'm not gonna lie to you, Carrot is one of the worst Counter-Strike players I've ever played with in my entire life. Like, it's just, like, I'm gonna be honest, like, I've played with people that are horrible, and he's up there. He's not the worst, though. There was this kid named Caucasian Wanderer that used to play on Dillman, and he played Counter-Strike 2, by far the worst player I've ever seen in my entire life. I don't think he knew what a mouse and keyboard were. Awesome kid, though. I'm still talking about CS. Awesome kid, you know? Good guy and everything. But, like, it actually might have been his computer, to be perfectly honest. Carrot, on the other hand, had a good computer. Has a good computer. Really bad.
So, like, I wouldn't know.
You were better than Carrot.
Sorry, Mark.
I'm sorry, Kat. No, I'm sorry.
Mark, you could be a silver one, and I'd say you're better than Carrot.
Okay.
So am I better than Carrot? This is a really important
question. Yes.
You know...
Am I?
Am I really... You know, back, like, when we were doing the Dillman, like, 2v2s and 3v3s, I really wanted you just to 1v1 Carrot. And if you won, it would have been the greatest day of my life.
I'll still do that. I will do that, but I'll need to practice a little bit, because I haven't even played Gmod recently, and Gmod's the same, you know, like, basis.
Kind of, yeah. It's on the Source engine, yeah.
Yeah. So, it's got the same engine. It's kind of a similar game, even if the guns aren't exactly the same. So, I'd need to continuously kind of practice doing things, which I've totally gotten out of practice. I've been playing Gmod recently, and I'm so bad.
Yeah, I mean...
I cringe at myself, because I'm like, Back in the old days when I was really good at this, I could have gotten this shot, like, bam, right there. But I don't even hit people anymore. I just kind of spray around them, you know, like in the spy movies, when the bad guy hits everywhere except for the person that they're supposed to shoot. That's me. That shooter.
That's me. So. I'm the bad shooter, yeah. Yeah, I don't know. But carrots, I mean, carrots, yeah, is pretty bad. Just gonna throw that out there. I've said it once, I'll say it again. Can't think of too many other people who are that horrible.
It could be.
I mean, like, I can think of a lot of people that are horrible, but I don't want to hurt their feelings because they actually might watch this, so. Throwing this out there. Yeah. I said that. Now, if my friends are watching this, they're like, shit, is he talking about me? Good talk.
Yeah, so. Do we have any other topics?
Why would you think I had topics?
Because you're.
Oh, do I hear the return with McDonald's?
Oh yeah.
Oh,
yeah.
Let's
Yay.
Go. Oh, Derek. Okay, so I wanted to see if you'd accept the terms and conditions of this. You know how we're doing a Background Noise 10 man, like, eventually, right?
Mm-hmm.
I'm gonna sit out and I'm gonna shoutcast it. And cool. I decided, I think we're gonna name two captains for each team. I think one captain is gonna be Chance and the other captain is gonna be you.
Sounds good. I have first pick.
Nope, actually, you're gonna 1v1 Chance. So you get first pick. But yeah, then whoever wins the 1v1 gets first pick.
That's good.
And
what'd you get from McDonald's?
So I got two Big Macs for $5.
Oh shit, it's so much cheaper in the States.
Mm-hmm.
How much you pay?
I pay close to $10.
But that's in Canadian.
Yeah.
Yeah. So probably like eight.
It's yeah, cause
seven.
Our dollars were 70 cents there, I think.
No, no. It's like backwards. 78 cents to the dollar.
Yeah, that's what I meant.
It's not good though.
Yeah. No bueno. I don't know. I'd like that idea for the 10 man. To be honest, I think it
That'd
would, because like you and Chance tilt each other anyway, and I just picture you guys not playing and just trying to tilt each other in chat the entire time.
Yep.
Which would be amazing. And we don't have the full like 10 people yet, so we can't even do it anytime soon. But like this, in a few
but
weeks.
But I'll be there. Definitely.
Exactly. We'll get you. I think I'm gonna try to get Ryan to play, maybe a few other people like that, because like I don't know who else we can get to play.
I mean, we have to go back in the episodes to find some guests for...
I mean, like, I could totally ask, like, the three people up there, too. And, because they've all been in Background Noise before.
Yeah, true.
And that would work out. So, okay, I'm trying to figure out what category I want to go to next, or topic.
Category?
This is categories and topics, you know?
Oh my god, Kat, I swear to god.
Sorry.
Oh, wow, I see what you did. Huh.
You don't like my puns?
Okay. Alright,
this is why ELs are better.
Listen.
Wow. So...
Rachel's, at least, we have a sense
I'm
of
I'm gonna
humor.
Put, a point in the EL category right now. One little tally mark, okay.
There, because they go. Don't make dumb puns?
That's two
dumb
points in the EL
there.
Category?
No, because they actually make funny puns.
There is
Big
no
difference.
Such thing.
Either. If I chuckle, it's a funny pun.
No matter what kind of pun you make, you will always get people that go, oh my god, and you will always get the people that laugh. It
Are
just
you sure
depends
it's not just your puns? It could just be your puns.
No. I mean, these are the puns made...
Oh my god.
What?
Why?
That's his name.
It is. What, so do you say Seth Bezos the pun?
Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah.
That was his actual name.
He made...
That's
yeah, it's a, okay.
He obviously made puns in his time at Dillman, and there were always people that laughed, that was me, and then the people that went, oh my god. And there's always, because puns are kind of stupid. They're clever, but they're like kind of that cringeworthy dad joke kind of thing, too.
Huh, his name's still Steph Hayes, just a pun. I looked him up on Steam. I didn't know if I still had him on Steam. I do.
He was a cool guy. I missed him.
He's an interesting individual, yeah. We'll say that much.
He was pretty cool.
Interesting guy.
He was very good at the game. I would always terrify to face him in that game because he's pretty good.
He's alright, yeah.
he was pretty good at Garry's Mod, and
I mean,
was a small amateur.
He was. I'm just gonna throw this out there.
Know how to shoot.
Being good at Garry's Mod literally means nothing. So I just.
I mean, in the game, it matters because if I was a terrorist, I would have to face him.
But everyone's a terrorist, Kat.
I would.
Everyone in the game's a terrorist.
If I was a traitor and it was my job to kill all of the innocents in the game, and Phasers was one of the innocents, then I would have to kill Phasers, or one of my teammates would. But if all my teammates sucked, then I would have to kill him. Because most of the time, I would be the better of the bad teammates. So, like, Phasers terrified me because he was good at that game, and I was not. And whenever I did kill him, there was this sense of pride that just welled up in my chest, and I was so happy because I killed, like, the best player in the game. So,
he was okay.
Did you yell in chat, set Phasers to done?
Alright, I'm taking a... Because of that, I have to erase the point from the EO, because an EO stating the thing that just made that shitty pun. Alright, now it's 0-0 again. Oh, yeah, wait, you laughed? Okay, back at EO again.
I think
EO's up 1-0 again.
What?
You laughed at that pun.
No matter how
my girlfriend was smacked me for it, so that is fair.
Exactly.
Most of the time, I laugh at puns, at least internally, because I think that they are pretty funny. Even unless they're like.
Do you mean really punny?
unless.
I'm gonna kill myself.
Unless they're, like, really, really bad, and they are just so failed, because you can have those. I've been, like, my sister's been watching some TV shows, and they have some pretty dumb puns in there, and you're like, that's, like, barely a joke. That's not even acceptable.
Well, question, is it, like, on the Disney Channel?
It's not Disney Channel.
Nickelodeon.
It's on Cartoon Network. A bunch of these shows that she finds, so.
Okay. There are a lot of bad TV shows.
They're not necessarily bad. They just sometimes tell these really stupid puns and jokes that you're just like, this. Why? It's not even funny. Don't give me this canned laughter. Because you know all those TV shows, like they have that fake laughter recording that plays.
Laugh track, yeah.
It's laugh track.
Yeah.
The best part is all those people who record that laugh track are dead.
Yeah.
Really?
The generic laugh track is like 80 years old, they still use it to this day. It's like 95% of the people who recorded that original laugh track are dead.
Yep, so they're dead people not laughing at your jokes.
Yeah.
I wonder how they feel about that. You know, like, as their souls, like, I can't believe that they're using my laughter for this stupid joke. Can you imagine being like a ghost in the ghost
and like every
realm,
time you cringe,
like hearing this canned laughter laugh track on all these TV shows with bad jokes, good jokes, bad jokes, but especially with the bad jokes, like, and you're just like, how dare you use my laugh for this?
I did not laugh at that.
I would never laugh at that. That's a horrible joke.
What? When did they record that? How did they record that? Did it just probably like a bunch of people just get together and start laughing? Or was there something to like spark this laughter?
I don't know.
I'm really curious now.
Yeah, not too sure about that. I do have topics we could jump to.
We can do that. I would actually like to play Cards Against Humanity tonight, if that is okay with this group of people.
It depends. So, Jordan, yeah. Derek, do you want a global grind or Cards Against Humanity? I'll leave it up to you guys. You don't have to decide now. You can wait to have the podcast instead.
Okay.
Wait, are we global grinding?
Global grind or Cards Against Humanity? Yes.
The oldest laugh track that's currently still used is from the 1950s.
Oh.
So say they're 20, born 1930. Would be in their mid-80s, like 86.
So yeah.
They could be dead, yeah.
Yeah.
Realistically, could still be alive, though.
Yeah.
It's over 60 years old, so yeah, that's still possible.
Yeah.
No, they just had a bunch of babies.
What?
Can you imagine a laugh track of laughing babies?
That would actually be... Okay, that'd be either really adorable or really creepy. One of the two. Can't really tell you until I hear it.
I know, that's how you make orphanages profitable.
Oh.
No.
Guys.
Hey, kids, you want to get adopted? Laugh.
I have an idea. Jordan, this is mostly to you.
Okay.
An orphanages? Oh, sorry. Words. What's the word? Orphanages. Hello?
Orphanages.
Okay.
Yeah. Dude, fuck sorcerers.
Yeah, right? Don't you want to punch an orphan in the mouth?
Yeah, fuck them.
See? That's what they use for. We could just, like, keep... So I have an idea. We just hire, like, 10 orphans to stand in a line next to Jordan all day. And at any time he's angry, just takes his anger out on them.
No.
But then once the anger is taken out of that one, it falls to the back of the line and has 9 more tries. So just hope if they're like...
It should just be a service.
It should be, right? Like, but, like, depending on what order they get, they could draw, like, a good, like, the longest straw and get, like, number 10. And you'd have to be angry 10 times a day. And it's not possible sometimes, you know? If you had a good day.
You lost me. Explain the concept.
Okay, so... Alright, we're gonna keep a line of 10 orphans next to you at all times. Right?
Okay.
And then, like, orphan number 1 is the first one you take your anger out on. So if you're orphan number 10... It takes
a good chance that you don't get hit that day.
Exactly. So there are good days as an orphan.
What I was saying is we should just make an orphanage and create a service where you can punch an orphan if you're angry.
Oh!
And we'll have lots of races so that if people are racist, then they can punch whatever race they want.
I like this. This is a great idea.
I will say, the way that we have to make it legal would be to use boxing gloves.
No,
that'd have to be the way to make it legal.
We'll just keep, like, your ragtag pair of boxing gloves?
Knuckles.
Yeah. I'm liking the way Jordan's going with this, yeah. I think spiked brass knuckles.
I mean, they're
actually
orphans. No one really cares about
them. I got specialty. You get shark teeth brass knuckles.
I'm liking the way you think.
Yeah. Yeah, let's go. That's what I was thinking. I didn't know what they were called, though.
Does it have a special name? Like, shark teeth brass knuckles, maybe? Mark, I feel like you know this.
I don't actually.
Okay.
I'm not that psychotic.
I don't know. It's 50-50. But yeah, we'll just make the orphanages, we'll see. We need, like, every kind of baby, though, you know? Every kind of orphan. Tall ones, short ones, like, average. Because sometimes you just want to beat up an average orphan, you know? And, like, we should have, like... You guys ever see, like, old people play bingo? And, like, there's all, like, the numbered balls in there?
Mm-hmm.
We just put the orphan's names on the ball, and you can choose to pick a random orphan.
Yeah.
And if their number comes out, that's the orphan. Oh, yeah. No, it should be numbers, because we don't give orphans names.
You know, shark teeth brass knuckles are actually pretty rare.
Really?
I mean, that could make us even more popular. It's a specialty shop.
Yeah, people might pay just to use the brass knuckles or shark teeth on them, and they might not even care it's the orphans.
They might just literally say, oh, bring out a punching bag instead.
No, well, we can't do that. No. We'd bring an orphan, but...
Well, what we do is we put an orphan in a bag and then hang up the bag, and then they can...
I like the way you think.
Yeah, that's perfect.
You know, this is horrible. My grandfather was an orphan. So this is perfect for me to be talking about. You know,
don't use that. How you learned how to punch?
Look, but you know, if anyone could make this joke, I think it's me. So just throwing it out there. So if you're an orphan and you're upset, we're talking about beating up orphans. You know, you're the perfect candidate to join our orphanage.
You want to volunteer?
We're looking for volunteers before we steal kids. I mean, find them on the street. Hey, Derek.
Derek's an orphan.
Oh, yeah.
I mean, even if he's not, some quick work with his
See, I was actually gonna, get Derek to, like, steal children. Because, like, the whole go fast man thing.
And he can recognize his own kind.
That's fucked, dude.
I wonder if Derek's here and angry, or if he's just gone. Again.
I think he went for a second
McDonald's. Did he go to McDonald's again? Was he hungry?
Oh yeah, he just went away.
If he snapshot me, I'm craving again. I'm like, Derek, he's skinny now, but not anymore. See, did he leave before or after Orphan Talk? I don't know.
I think it would be before. You have to be AFK how long? Like 5 minutes or 15 or something?
For it to go to LA?
Yeah.
I don't know.
I feel like it's like 15 or 10.
It's gotta be at least like, it's gotta be more than 5 at least.
Yeah, Tony, I think I'm gonna head out for the night.
Okay.
Wow, man. I'm just gonna...
Look, I was here on time.
You know.
And I had to wait for a half hour.
You know, I'm Sandman. Part,
like 40.
You did, actually, because TeamSpeak did give us a lot of problems and stuff, so.
Yeah.
All right, man. Thanks for coming on. Appreciate you.
Anytime.
Yeah.
Anytime.
Have a wonderful night.
Have a good night, my man. Peace.
Good night.
Derek's back!
So, I just went downstairs to, disconnected from your channel.
Mark had to go.
Mark.
He left.
Right. So, I just went downstairs to throw my crap out, and my garbage can's right next to my, sliding, like, glass door, and I look out, and there's this big-ass deer, like, on my patio, just sitting there, just chilling, having a great time. It took me really off guard. You know, I just thought you'd like to know that. He was just, like, chilling there, like, he looked at me, he was like, what's up?
He's like, what up? You're like, hey, didn't expect to see you here, do you come here often? Deer's like, actually, every Saturday night. Oh.
That, like, made my night.
Yeah.
You know what has been happening? Okay, so I live in the middle of nowhere, all right? I live, like...
Are you encouraged to carry my dog?
No.
You sure?
I can't. But anyway, I live in the middle of nowhere.
He lives in the middle of nowhere.
Town. Very close to a very small town. I live in an even smaller town next to that small town by a lake. So, it's pretty small. So, I mean, every day have been taking like a jog, run, walk kind of thing up this one road and then back down to my house, you know, so I started this over break so I wouldn't like die, and because I'd be sitting at my computer 24/7. Anyway, every single day recently I have been seeing some sort of like wildlife out there because it's springtime and everything's like happening, all these things are coming out. So one time I saw, like, this little brown thing, like, scurry across the road. I had no idea what it was. It probably was a woodchuck. Because
how much would a
woodchuck
chuck if a woodchuck could chuck wood?
That's the real question.
I don't know, man. I didn't see him chuck
wood. I've never actually seen a woodchuck before in my entire life.
They're pretty weird. But
someone did the math at some point on that.
Really?
Great.
Yeah. There's a post somewhere on Reddit.
Yeah. But I saw that, and then the next day, I saw a skunk. It was not really close to me, so I was pretty safe, and I just kind of, like, walked slowly at that point, and I just got away from it, and it, like, went into the trees or something, I don't know.
The woodchucks look like a weird, like, groundhog type of thing.
Yeah, they do. I think it could have been, it was, like, brown, and it was kind of, like, fuzzy.
Fuzzy. I just googled, like, I'm just looking at them in Google Images. Yeah, they look like, that's exact. They look fluffy. Like, not fluffy, at least fuzzy.
Yeah, it could have been one of those things. They're kind of weird. Anyway, I saw a skunk, and then it's like, the other day it was bird day. I call it bird day because there were so many birds, it's not even funny. They were everywhere. Like, it's mating season, probably, because, you know, like, when birds, like, there's one and it flies away and then another one chases it.
But aren't, your cat shouldn't be happy? There's a lot of birds. You eat birds.
Sure. But there's a lot of birds and you can hear them. You're just walking down the road and you just hear all of these birds. It's almost overwhelming. But it was crazy how many birds there were. And last night, I think it was last night, that I took a walk.
Like 24.
And there was this thing. I was not wearing my glasses, and it was dark out, so I couldn't tell what it was. I thought it was a cat. Okay? I see it. I'm right by, like, a lamp post, so it's pretty bright where I am, but the light fades out as it gets close to the cat, so I can't really see this thing. It looks gray. It's standing up, like, standing, not standing, but sitting with his feet, like, right in front of it, so, like, you know, kind of natural cat pose. I think it's a cat, so I, like, slowly take steps towards it, and I, like, put out my hand, and I go, like, come here, kitty, you know, like you do with cats. And it, like, it scurries away. It does not run like a cat. I know how cats run, and it did not run like a cat. And I just got so terrified because I did not know what it was. I'm pretty sure it wasn't a cat. Now that I think about it, like, after I did that, I was thinking about it, and I was like, that was not a cat, was it? It could have, honestly, it had, like, a ringed tail, so it could have, we don't have these around here, but it looked like one of those,
sounds like a raccoon.
What is it? What are those things? I had the name in my head this morning.
They're
in
like?
Madagascar.
Lemurs?
They're in Madagascar. Yes, it looked like a lemur. But we don't have those around here.
So no, yeah, I don't think you do. I don't think upstate New York has no. Lemurs, typically, at least. But, at least not during this time of year.
So it could have been a cat that ran funny, or it could have been like a raccoon or something.
My money's on raccoon. But so in case anyone cares, I just googled, how much wood could a woodchuck chuck if a woodchuck could chuck wood? And it's about 700 pounds.
Nice. Yeah.
That's cool.
Yeah.
I mean, it didn't have, like, the black around its eyes. I was blind, so it could have, but I just might not have seen it. But I was, like, after that, I was terrified because did I just try to get a raccoon to come to me?
What if you could have been petting a raccoon?
I mean... Wild animals kind of scare. I know they really shouldn't, like, all the time. Like, I shouldn't be scared of, like, squirrels, and I shouldn't be scared of, like, I don't know, birds or something. But I am. If one is pretty close to me, and it's not scared of me, I get kind of scared, because that's not okay. Like, I don't know. I don't know why I'm so terrified. I don't want to get attacked or something. I don't want to get attacked by a raccoon. They're not domesticated.
That's
so
true. That would not be any fun to be attacked by.
Like, I don't... It's really risky, and I was kind of, like, terrified. Like, what if that thing actually came towards me and it was not a cat?
Would have been pretty sketch, honestly. Probably would have died.
But I would have had a nice story to tell if I survived.
The time where I called a raccoon thinking it was a cat.
Mm-hmm. And it came to me, and I petted it. Although, raccoons are adorable, so...
They're adorable when they're not filled with
rabies. I just remembered Ron the Fox.
Yeah.
I want him. Ron the Fox, have you guys seen him?
Yeah. This was a podcasting once that we talked about.
Mm-hmm. We were looking up this fox. He's amazing. And he's adorable.
It's basically like a domesticated fox that a guy owns.
Mm-hmm. He's so cool.
Okay.
It's kind of pretty a cool concept, honestly.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. So, I mean, Hydro, do you have any other topics?
You know, I'm actually thinking about ending it right here.
Okay. On Cat's crazy tales of
Of raccoon death. Almost raccoon death, mm-hmm. I should say. So, everyone, thank you for watching.
Thank you for listening.
I appreciate all of you, and thanks for the comment. Goodbye.